Hey, horse people. Woo, it's stinking smoking out here. A lot of humidity. Man, I'm sweating my butt off. Sweating more than a hooker on nickel night. So I'm going to do a video on a... get into this mud here. On trailer loading. And somebody asked, could I do for two trailers instead of just one? But when I was hosing Buddy off, I picked up some behavior that I wanted to point out and share, so hopefully he will do it again. So I'm gonna go hose Buddy butts off. And on Buddy now, when you're hosing a horse off, you gotta know how much pressure is enough and how much is enough. You wanna start soft, get him used to it, and then you can kinda go down and get him used to taking some hard pressure. So what I was doing, as I was washing, because all this rich grass, this spring grass has come out, the horse's crap's been really green and just rich. And you can tell it's rich because they got kind of, I call it alfalfa diarrhea, but it's that really rich diet and they kind of have the runs. But when they have the runs, their butt gets dirty here and they have this dry crap here. And when I see that, I always want to rinse it off because I don't want to have itchy butt and be running around with dried crap on her ass collecting flies. So as I'm cleaning this off, I was getting kind of aggressive. And you can't see Buddy's face, but I want you to watch his feet when I get too aggressive. And he's not going to do it. Before, when I did this, he kind of lifted his foot up a little bit like, hey, you're getting a little too aggressive. And I stopped, and I went back to here, and it popped in mind, and one of my viewers would be like, well, you shouldn't stop when he's irritated, because then you teach him that irritating is the right response, and if he lifted his leg, he was threatening to kick, and if he threatens to kick and you stop, then he learns that if I kick you, you'll stop. And all that's true, but it also depends. It depends on the horse. I don't think he was threatening to kick me when he lifted his leg. He was telling me, dude, that's a little uncomfortable. I don't feel like standing here. So I gave him some release, not completely stopped. I moved the pressure from here and went up here with less pressure. So he didn't associate lifting the foot with me stopping what I was doing. That was kind of irritating. So I'm going to try to get a little more aggressive here. Because he had some dry poop here, so I was really scratching it off and getting this kind of straight. There he goes. See a foot? I'm going to do it again. See a foot? Is he threatening to kick me, or is he saying, dude, kind of put a little pressure on me. What do you want? Do you want me to move? Because normally, if I tell him to move, he moves away from pressure. So he moved away from that pressure, asking a question. A lot of times horses will do something, and they're actually asking you a question. Is this what you want? Is this the right answer? Is this pressure to get me to move so I'll move? Or is it pressure for something else? I don't know. Is this pressure to make him move, or is it pressure to rinse him? He doesn't know, so he has to learn through continuous training and through continuous interaction what you want. That's why, I mean, you can do a lot if you understand pressure release with a horse relatively quick, but you have to be always looking and listening to the horse. Buddy lifted his leg. When I got too much pressure on here, was he threatening to kick? Was he telling me to stop? I didn't see any of that. I didn't see his ear pinning. I didn't see him snap that neck back and go, hey, knock it off, like he's trying to get a fly off his belly. I didn't see any really quick, jerking, threatening maneuvers. What I saw was, hey, dude, that's kind of rough. Damn, that kind of feels uncomfortable. Am I supposed to move, or are you just cleaning? He doesn't know. So with new horse owners especially, you always get this, everything a horse does is personal. You know better than that. You shouldn't have done that. You're just being stubborn. You're being stupid and mean and all this other crap. When in actuality, the horse is probably just like, dude, I'm confused. I don't know what you're doing. We haven't done this enough to know. I mean, there's some horses, if I walk up with this much of a stream, oh shit, I hope I didn't get the camera, and go, let me go check that camera. On my gun channel, I can't have over. Shit, I better clean that. On my gun channel, I can't have over 15 minutes, so I don't have that problem here, so if I go over, it's no big deal. So, again, what I wanted to cover was pressure and release, communicating with your horse, understanding. Hi, buddy. Buddy, better day, you're good boys. We're going to do a trail loading video. They're like, oh, shit, we're going to go somewhere. Nah, I'm just going to load you and let you out. So, again, pressure and release. Whenever a horse does something, you need to be able to interpret and think with your head and use your damn head for more than a damn helmet holder that, hey, is my horse asking, is he confused, is he threatening, is he not knowing what to do, so he's trying different things to try and figure out what the right answer is? Am I putting too much pressure? Am I confusing the horse? Am I giving the horse confusing and contradictory clues, just like most people do in their round pen? They got both damn hands up and can't figure out why the horse don't know which way to go. And they got both hands up and they always shake the rope and they never stop shaking the rope, and the heart goes in there and runs and they're like, my horse doesn't round pin, he's stupid, Rick. Yeah, that's my stupid voice. All right, so anyway, that's on pressure and release, reading a horse. Not every time a horse lifts his leg, looks at you, pins his ears, moves away to you, moves into you, is a personal assault, disrespect, mean, bad, untrainable, blame it on the last trainer, blame it on the breeding, blame it on the pink blanket because he likes purple, whatever. Stop with all the excuses and accept responsibility when you do something with a horse. Always realize a horse is a reflection of you. Whatever he's doing is because of you. Notice Buddy isn't lifting his leg at me right now. Gee, Rick, why is that? He's not lifting his single leg at me because I'm not over there irritating, squirting water up his butt. Because he did what he did because of what I was doing. So if I'm getting the wrong response and I'm not getting the right answer, it's my job to help the horse understand. They're getting tangled up. Buddy, where are you going? I got you both tied up around your neck. You can't stand still. What the hell? Mr. T, you're in big trouble. Buddy's over. You're getting beaten. All right, so we'll go ahead and end that there and then I'll do my trailer loading. Somebody asked, I've got a lot of trailer loading videos, but somebody asked, could I do two horses in one trailer because I only show one? And I've never done a two loading both horses. So I'll load both horses, each one taking a turn in the front and each one taking a turn in the back. And we'll see. Poor Mr. T. See what he puts up with that youngster? He's like, dude, can't you just stand still so I can relax? Why you got to keep eating and pulling on my rope and moving around? Mr. T, I know. You can't teach those damn youngsters nothing. Turn around, put a boot in his ass. He'll listen. All right, let me end that there and we'll start on trailer loading.